Let's move on over to the KCRA 3 Kitchen and Miss Adrienne Benkert.
Are you hungry?
I always am.
Yeah, and today's KCRA 3 Kitchen, I think you're going to love this, Eileen. And you at home, we're giving you a taste of history, very fitting, on California's birthday. Chef Robb Venditti from Mulvaney's in Sacramento. Also, Lisa Malloy from Friends of Sutter's Fort joining us to talk about a great event at the end of the month for people who love California history. So, Robb, what are we making today?
We are making bacon cheddar and corn dumplings.
Yum.
Yep.
Okay, so kind of like a
scone. I'm going to get them started real quick, throw them in the oven.
Start it out, and we'll do it with the magic of television.
It's real simple. I don't know why anybody would use Bisquick. It's a cup of all-purpose flour, mm-hmm. 2 teaspoons baking powder, about a half teaspoon of salt there. Just mix that up a little.
Because they didn't have Bisquick in the 1800s.
No, they didn't. So this would be really easy. Okay. A lot of the stuff, you would instead of bacon, they'd probably be using salt pork. But pretty similar.
Salt pork is good.
Yep.
Just maybe not good for your heart.
Right.
But it's tasty. Okay, Lisa, so as Robb is stirring this up.
A couple tablespoons of butter.
Uh-huh.
And then a half cup of milk. And then you just want to combine that. That's your basic
dumpling
or biscuit recipe right there.
Mm-hmm.
So we're just going to mix that all together.
You don't even have a whisk or egg beater or
anything.
Thing
about this. You don't really want to overmix it. That's the only thing. You just want to kind of combine all your ingredients.
Okay.
That's what makes a nice, moist, fluffy biscuit there.
Okay.
Then I'm just going to throw in some corn and some cheddar into there.
All right.
A little white cheddar. We got Bravo Farms farmhouse cheddar.
Local cheese.
Uh-huh. And then, so there's a lot of different ways you can do these too. My favorite, I love these things right here. You can get them at Target for like $12.
I love how we all call it Target now.
Yeah,
it used to be Target, now it's Target.
So, oops, got a little stove, but
that's okay.
We'll just drop a little in there.
You know,
can also do them just like free form on a, I mean, you could boil these. That's what a dumpling is. Just like that, little cupcake cups. However you want to do it.
However you want to do it.
Sure.
While you're finishing these off with some bacon, Lisa, you're with Friends of Sutter's Fort. And basically, this is an event that highlights the foods that John Sutter would have enjoyed back in the day.
Right. It's an opportunity to take the foods that he would have enjoyed and yet spin them to the modern palate and make them exciting.
And make them yummy. And mm-hmm. Mulvaney's kind of adding a twist. I'm sure everybody will enjoy that gourmet twist. Let's see what they look like when they're finished.
So I'm putting them in the oven now at 350 degrees. If you have convection like we do here, it works great. Let me get this one out. Let me, oh, come
here.
Oh, that's
here,
hot.
Here,
that's hot. That's hot.
Oh, careful.
All right. So that's what they look like when
come
out.
Oh, what kind of oven did you use?
In the other oven down here, too. So.
Oh, wow. Okay, perfect.
Here's the finished product. Real
finished
good,
product,
real easy.
Really basic.
A meal in a cup there.
Okay, we'll taste these. But Lisa, this dinner is a big event for Sutter's Fort. For anybody who was like me and the kids in my family, we all went to Sutter's Fort as a field trip. Those programs supported by this event. It's coming up September 25th, is that right? And it's from 6:30 p.m. on. This is at Sutter's Fort. It's going to be a taste of history, a benefit for the Friends of Sutter's Fort. Again, you can join in on the history. And again, all these different restaurants are participating, not just Mulvaney's, but Plates Catering. Also, name a couple of them.
Cafe Vinoteca.
There you go.
Grange and Spataro.
Awesome. Okay, so tickets are $85. You can find more information on our website, kcra.com/morningnews. We'll be right back, and you'll have the recipe online as well.